The Office, arguably the most popular sitcom and at best the most entertaining and most loved mockumentary that's out there. I was quite late to the party with The Office, I didn't watch it until 2021, but safe to say I've watched it several times since finishing it. This show made me feel things that I've never felt before when watching a TV show, and that's something that's extremely unique about this show. The Office is life, and when watching through like I did, and I imagine many other people, all day, every day, you do form a real bond and connection with the characters in the show. We see the relationship between Pam and Jim, the friendship and understanding between Dwight and Jim, Michael's love and care for his family, and all of the other endeavors that the cast members get up to over the 9 years. With this, I thought I'd start the year off by talking about the show that had the most impact on me last year in 2021. And I'm going to share what I believe are the 5 best episodes of The Office. Before I go ahead, make sure you go over to my Twitter, @brainpilot_, and tweet me what show or movie you'd like me to review next. So without further ado, I'm Brain Pilot, and here are the 5 best episodes of The Office. Just to let you know, this video will contain spoilers, so watch with caution. Number 5. Murder. The episode that I believe is the 5th greatest episode of all time is Season 6, Episode 10, an episode titled Murder. This is an episode that I believe shows multiple levels to different characters in The Office. The episode starts off like any other, nothing in particular happens. However, it soon gets revealed that the future of Dunder Mifflin is uncertain based on an article that has been posted in the Wall Street Journal. From here on, the episode begins. With all of the uncertainty and panic going on, people stop doing their work, which is what you would imagine would happen. Why do work if you're going to lose your job? This episode is at a point where we have 2 managers of Dunder Mifflin Scranton. We've got Michael and Jim, and they both handle the news completely differently. We see Jim rally up the troops and want them to work despite knowing the uncertainty of his future and the company. And we see Michael go into complete panic, dwell, and feel miserable, leading him to blast power ballads from his office, a moment that was quite funny. This requires Jim to go in and give him a pick-me-up and tell him that he needs to pull it together. This is how I would expect the 2 characters to react, and there were no surprises there. Michael's response to this is to distract everybody in the office by playing a murder mystery game that's based in Savannah. The cast adopt these fictional characters and put on these accents that I think are absolutely hilarious. I love the part where Andy corrects Pam's accent, that's an all-time moment for me. It's pretty clear that Jim isn't comfortable doing this, and the constant worry is overtaking him due to it feeling like nobody, and especially Michael, is not taking it seriously. It's here where we see Jim pull Michael into his office, and we see a reaction from Michael that I feel we rarely get to see. He's angry with Jim. And this is where I believe we see Michael's experience as a manager come into effect, as Jim doesn't even argue back. Michael states that the team need this game, and it makes total sense. Michael has used his experience and knowledge as a manager to know how to handle these situations. We see at the start Michael Scott as a person, not a manager, react to the news, because he genuinely cares about Dunder Mifflin, and is probably worried about his own future. But as the episode goes on, he adopts his managerial position more, and it comes to fruition, and the way he distracts, puts his staff at ease, and allows them to enjoy a day that could provide some terrible news and change their lives, is how we know Michael is a good manager and is good at his job. We see this all the way up until the end, where Jim receives a phone call from Wallace with bad news. But Jim is now on the side of playing the game because that's what they needed that day. It's a fantastic episode that shows the level of management skills that Michael has, and that there is sometimes logic behind the chaos and immature front that he puts on. Number 4. Dinner Party. For many people, this is their all-time favorite, and it's safe to say it's a fantastic episode. There are many things that make this episode great. We have the original plan that Michael does by lying to everyone when saying that they have to make sure that they have their evening free due to working late. All for it to be a lie so that he can guarantee Jim and Pam are available to attend his dinner party. Typical Michael Scott behavior. Once the dinner party begins, it essentially becomes the dinner party from hell. We have the toxicity between Michael and Jen all evening. It's clear that they shouldn't be together, but for some reason they are. We've got the food not even started cooking, the awkward dinner party games, Jan's love for Hunter coming to the forefront, the awkward tour around the house with the reveal of Michael's tiny bed at the bottom, where we essentially see him being treated like a dog. It's done for comedic effect, but it's also an extremely sad moment. We get to see how Michael is treated outside of the office. We see the underlying jealousy that Jan has, despite the fact it feels like she doesn't even really love him that much. It's an episode that contains many classic moments in The Office, such as the flat-screen TV moment and the luminous blue light. I think the episode also represents the role Michael plays in Jan's life and their relationship. Michael is suppressed, his dundies are kept in a cabinet, she dominates all of the rooms, his signs are in the garage, and he sleeps on a stand at the end of the bed. There is nothing of Michael in the house, and that's all a representation of their relationship, and it's executed perfectly on screen with these details. This episode balances comedy and emotions really well, and knows how to lean into each of them when necessary. Number 3. Goodbye, Michael. I think it would be difficult to not put this one on this list. This is quite comfortably one of the best episodes in the show. There is only one thing I dislike about this episode, and that is Will Ferrell. I hate the fact that they included him in the show because his character is just so annoying. And at points took away from an episode that could have been the perfect episode of The Office. I think what got me on Goodbye Michael even more was that I didn't know that Steve Carell had ever left the show. So as I mentioned earlier, I'd built a relationship with this character and he was now leaving, without me even knowing if it was for good. We'd seen on occasions in the past that Michael Scott was going to move on, but it never happened. However, this time it felt real. We got to see Michael in all of his glory, the good and the bad. Michael has a list of people that he wants to say goodbye to, and we see him one by one work his way through his list. The slight interactions and far stronger interactions with other characters. He says his goodbyes in the way that's true to himself. We also got to see a glimpse of the real emotions when we see Jim say goodbye, but not goodbye, to Michael Scott. The pair's emotions were real, as it was two friends saying goodbye to each other, and that comes across the screen well. This episode is a complete emotion ball, and it hits you every time. The episode really does hit the hammer on dialing up the viewer's emotions, but also still having that underlying comedy and moments of laughter when watching the episode. It's got a longer runtime of 50 minutes, and it deserved it. It never dragged, it never felt heavy, and it never felt slow. It was the end of a chapter in The Office, and you could say from there on, the show was never the same. Number 2. Finale. Well, the genuine final chapter in The Office, an extremely long runtime which it definitely deserved and needed, whilst containing heaps of emotion that I never thought I'd experience when watching a show. Weeks of watching all led to this episode, and boy was it worth it. After a dismal season 8 and a season 9 that was lacking something but felt like its sole purpose was to set up this episode, the finale was the perfect ending to The Office. It far outweighed any theory or ending that I had in my head. I thought it was the right way for the show to go. We see the cast a year later after the premiere of the show, and they all come together for one final time to do a Q&A panel which rounded off the arcs of many of the beloved characters. Erin got to see her parents for the first time. We learnt that Meredith was studying during filming, hence all of the crazy moments that she had. Oscar is running in local government. Stanley retired in Florida. And also that many of the characters had moved on from Dunder Mifflin. We got to see Dwight go on to marry Angela and the stag do which incorporated visiting Kevin at his bar that he now owned due to being fired. And also, Dwight finally became the manager of Dunder Mifflin's Scranton branch. Many of the arcs were resolved in a way that felt natural and appropriate. Also, Dwight and Jim's friendship being acknowledged as them being best friends. Relationships and moments in The Office came to a natural resolution in this episode, without it being forced or deliberate. We also got to see Michael Scott return briefly, and it was just fantastic. All moments in this episode were great, but the final scene with them all in The Office cutting to clips old and new, with them each voicing over about their time working at Dunder Mifflin, with Creed playing a song in the background, was emotional, poetic, and the perfect way to close off the entire series. This episode really was incredible, and although not a classic Office episode, it is everything you'd love about the show in a 50-minute special, and it deserves to be where it is on this list. Number 1. Grief Counseling. Coming in at number one on this list is what I believe is the best and most funniest episode in The Office. It's titled Grief Counseling. If I'm being honest, I surprised myself when this became my favorite. It's my most watched and the one that I think is definitely the funniest. I think it sums up The Office to a T and portrays Michael Scott in the way that I feel everybody remembers him. We see The Office tackle something that it doesn't do often, if at all, and that's the subject of death. Something that in general is a difficult subject to talk about, let alone get across in a comedy show. In Grief Counseling, it's centered around Michael's mentor and boss, Ed Truck, being killed. When the announcement happens, it turns out he was decapitated, and although gruesome, that did make me chuckle. The initial reaction from Michael was for him to not believe that he was dead, to then putting on a piece of paper over his head on an image to imagine what it must have looked like without a head had me in stitches. I feel it's the small things like that that really do make The Office unique. There were constant updates throughout the episode that were announced to The Office with Dwight interrupting, which I thought was just brilliant. Then cutting to the shots to the rest of the cast reacting in disgust and repulse to the information that was being broadcast the way it was absolutely hilarious. There are then two other parts to this episode. We have the actual grief counseling moment itself, where they're in the conference room, which Pam quickly gets excused from to try and avoid it. But Michael decides to wait before kicking off, which was so awkward and funny. Then down to the fact that everyone was discussing deaths in movies when Michael was being so serious. This finishes with Michael running downstairs to save a bird that flew into the window and eventually giving it a funeral. The complete chaos, panic, and expression from Michael Scott when he discovers the bird was absolutely hilarious. There's nothing else like it in The Office. Dwight trying to squeeze the bird into a can is still an image that I can't shake out of my mind because it's just too funny. I think this episode handles the topic of death extremely well, and although not delicate, we see different layers to Michael and the cast members. We see the wider cast not take it seriously, but then at the end when Michael needs them, they're there for him. In Michael we see the I can't believe it to the overbearing I want to save everything and make sure everyone is okay. Even though death is a certainty, the fear is always there, and Michael was expressing his loss and channeling it through the bird that was introduced into the show. The bird was essentially Ed Truck and Michael's own personal farewell to him. It's a fantastic episode, and whenever I put it on, I know I'm going to be laughing my head off. So, there you have it, what I believe are the five greatest episodes in The Office. The show has genuinely made me look at things differently, and the love that I have for these characters will always remain. It's a fantastic show, one of the best in my opinion, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Comment your five episodes below, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you next time.